Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We want to welcome you especially to this edition of the Daily Fountain of the Church of Nigeria, Anglican Communion. Today being the 10th day in the month of November 2017. Please kindly invite your friends, your family members together for a special time in presence of God, and I know that God is going to bless you a great deal. Let us pray. Father God, we ask again that at this moment, as we meditate on your word, that you will speak to us, because we believe that your word is yea and amen. Your word is life. At the entrance of this your word, give us understanding and insight to your praise and to your glory. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Beloved, today's topic is practical show of Christian love. And our text is taken from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1 to 6. I read, "I urge you then, I am a prisoner because I serve the Lord. Live a life that measures up to the standard God set when he called you. Be always humble, gentle, and patient. Show your love by being tolerant with one another. Do your best to preserve the unity which the Holy Spirit gives by the means of the peace that binds you together. There is one body and one spirit, just as there is one hope to which God has called you. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. There is one God and the Father of all, who is Lord of all, walks through all, and is in all." This is the word of the Lord, and thanks be to God. Practical love, practical show of Christian love. It is a thing of joy to count it worthy that it's not just by singing and preaching or talking about love. We know, of course, love is the unspeakable cord that binds all of us together. But it's another thing to demonstrate this love practically as the characteristics that identify us as Christian disciples. We can see this in John 13, verse 34 through 35. There can be no true unity, no glorious hope for the future of the body of Christ, unless we subject our egos and personal ambitions to the lordship of Christ. In the interest of his church and for the witness of him which we practice to the whole world, this love issue must be demonstrated within the context of having the mind of Christ. This can be seen in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 through to 11, that without which we exhibit the work of the flesh. You know, when you don't have love in you, you just exhibit flesh, and carnality will showcase. And these are the fruit of the flesh, the work of the flesh, as is shown in Galatians chapter 5, verse 19 to 21. Also in Romans 12, 3 to 8, Paul enjoined Christians not to think of themselves more highly than others. Rather, they should encourage one another to discover and to exercise the gift that builds a strong and a united house. And of course, this gift that builds a strong and a united house is the love of Christ that is inbuilt in us, that we showcase to the world, and that transforms the lives of humanity. In fact, what a personal sacrifice you are making when you have love, you are making sacrifice, a big time sacrifice, you know, which rules in the fellowship that is exhibited in the manifestation of the fruit of the Spirit. So when you show love, you are manifesting the fruit of the Spirit to the world And the fruit of the Spirit we're talking about now is Christ in you, which is the hope of glory. You will showcase it to the whole world. And people will see that love in you, and they get contagious with this love pattern that you showcase, and they turn to Christ without even preaching the gospel. Love is the ultimate. Beloved, let us examine ourselves and our lives if we are really showing love or practically demonstrating the love that Jesus came to this world to showcase. Can you imagine? God loves so loved the world that he gave his only son Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in him will not perish but will have everlasting life. So today we are asking that the spirit of love will invade your life, and this love will not just be a word of the mouth, but it should be practical love, a show of this Christian love. In fact, the agape love, which is sacrificial, that brought Jesus to this world. I believe you will deeply meditate on the practice of love, and the grace of God will help you to be not just the hearers, but the doers of this love. Go into the world and show love, and people will be blessed. Please let us pray. Eternal Rock of Ages, we thank you. Your word has comforts, urging us to practicalize love, not just by words of mouth, but the life we live. Lord, not just by any other thing, but surrendering our egocentric lifestyle and putting you first. Because we know that by this show of love, lives will be touched and transformed, and souls will be won into the kingdom. Because through this love, we become living witnesses of Christ in our community. Help us today, O God. We equally pray, O God, presenting every of our needs before you, as families, as a church, and as a people. Lord, reach out to us. There are so many out there who are denied of love. Lord, we pray, O God, that they will receive love. There are some who are grown up without love, live a life of hatred, and they have been deprived. Lord, we are asking that love will be shown to them, to your praise and to your glory. Blessed be your name. We pray that these words will remain indelible in our hearts, to your praise and to your glory. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. For in Jesus' perfect name, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, viewers. We just want you to look at the emails, the phone numbers, contact this wonderful organization of our church so that you can sponsor this program to the glory of God. See you next time. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen.